Hey guys, it's Tuesday, I hope you're all feeling well. What we've got for you today is Double Edge. What we've got is 7 rounds, 30 double unders, 20 10 metre shuttle runs, and then 10 burpees. Shuttle runs 10 metres, 10 big steps, we'll give you sort of your distance. We're going to go there and back, 10 times in total, so that'll be 20 complete shuttle runs. Double unders, we're going to find a variation that allows us to complete somewhere between 30 and 40 seconds each round. And then burpees, we stick to 10. We can either step back or jump back on these burpees, whatever variation you need to do to get through these today. I'm expecting this workout takes somewhere between 12 and 20 minutes. Nice steady one for you to get through today, just body weight movements. What we're going to start off with is a running warm-up. So what I'd like you to do is go for a 1 minute light jog. After that minute, I want you to increase the pace to a slow run, and I want you to finish off with a nice, moderate pace run to finish. If you pause the video now, go get that done. Awesome, welcome back guys. What we're gonna do is go straight into our next part of our warm-up. We're gonna start off with 30 seconds of jumping jacks. So hands up above the head, feet out on the bottom, nice and simple. Keep it up. Ah, so relax, we come straight down to the floor. From the top plank, we take a big step forward, left foot goes outside the left hand, into our active spine band. We can just make small circles of that front knee. Just looking to loosen those hips off as much as possible. And switch sides. Nice, and relax. Go grab your skipping rope if you haven't got it already. We're going to 30 seconds of nice, easy, single skips. If you haven't got a rope at home, you can just go into line hops. Good work. And we're going to push the down dog. So, top plank again. We can go for a push-up, we can drop the knees flat if we need to. We can send the hips up and back. Put the legs out a few times. And then go again on that push-up. That's one. Fantastic. Then we go straight into double taps. So we jump up, double tap the hips as you get to the top of that jump. And relax. We're going to finish off 30 seconds. Nice, easy, back squat. And relax, good job guys. Now we're gonna come into some mobility. So we're gonna start off with a couch stretch. If you find yourself just a little bit of space against the wall, or you could even use your couch, you're gonna take the knee to the wall, or whatever you're going to use to prop your leg up, put it down as close as you can, and come up into a full lunge. We're going to hang out here for for a minute. You make this easier by bringing the knee further away from the wall. Make it look harder by taking the knee closer. You can even reach up and overhead if you really want to increase that stretch. If it's okay for you today, you can just stay here. And ease off, and we're going to switch sides. So same thing, put all the knees looking for the wall, let's slide that knee down till it touches the floor, and come up into a lunge on that other side. If this is a little harsh on your knees, you can grab a jumper or a t-shirt or something, throw it underneath your knee, just take a little bit of that pressure off. Again, as we get to the end, you can just increase that stretch by leaning back slightly. And ease off. Good work. Then what we're going to do is we're going to find a post. We can use the same piece of wall. What we're going to do is we're going to do a calf stretch. So we take our toes as hard as we can. Heel nice and close. We're going to lean into that stretch through the calf. Always good to look after the calves if we've got any skipping to do. They can get pretty tight as we do see this. And switch sides. So again, yeah, toes nice and high, heel as close as you can, and just lean forward into that and in the back. Good work, guys. Now we're jumping into our teaching points. Cool. So the first thing we're talking about today is our running. If you haven't already got a 10-meter shuttle run set up or a distance that you know you can use today, I'd like to take this time now to pause the video and just go and set that up for yourself. Best thing to do is use a couple of markers, a couple of t-shirts, a couple of jumpers, something like that. 10 big steps, drop another one down, and you can just go from side to side there. It's going to be done in the garden, out on the front of your path, anywhere you like. You can even take a skipping rope outside somewhere a bit more interesting, in your back garden if you wanted to today. Now that that's sorted, what we're going to do next is we're going to take 30 seconds of a nice light jog between the two. Then we're going to increase that into a 30 second moderate pace. By moderate pace, I mean something you can see yourself sustaining for the entire 20 minutes that this could take. So we're looking for this workout to take somewhere between 12 and 20 minutes. We want to be able to keep these efforts sustainable so it doesn't become 20 10-meter sprints. One way to focus on as you jog and then moderate run between the two points is keep that chest nice and high. Keep that chest high and the head forward, focus on the horizon. It's going to mean we can keep the airways open, breathe nice and deeply, and really run with good posture. Off you go. So we're going to go 30 seconds light jog, 30 seconds a little bit quicker. Fantastic. We're going to jump straight into double unders now. So, grab your rope, we're going to go 30 seconds single skips, and 30 seconds of double unders. Again, what we're looking at is that head position. So we're going to try and concentrate on a point in the horizon. What that's going to do is hopefully mean when we jump, we stay in much straighter lines. So we're looking for that nice, neat pencil jump, whether we're in double unders or single skips. I'm going to do these ones with you. So we're going to start off 30 seconds, nice, easy, single skips. Then we go straight into 30 seconds of double unders. If you haven't got a skipping rope at home, a couple of options. You can use a broomstick or a mop. You can just jump over it, like I've laid the rope up. You can go 9 hops, or you can just jump in place and use those double taps like we did in that warm up. Either one of those will work. We're looking for those double unders to take somewhere between 30 and 40 seconds. So, a couple of options. You can do 30 double unders, 60 singles, or you can spend 30 to 40 seconds of double under practice. On a workout like this, 7 rounds is not necessarily a longer workout, but it's a higher number of rounds than we'd usually do. So mentally it can be quite tough. Don't get frustrated with the rope. Just go to singles, maybe do the first 2 rounds trying to practice some double unders so we can start creeping them into workouts. And then just move on to single skips to keep that momentum up and to not get too frustrated with the skipping rope throughout this workout. Next thing, burpees. Everybody's favorite. 2 gears in the burpees today. 10 burpees per round, 7 rounds in total, 70 burpees. So that's quite a lot of burpees to get done today. What I'd recommend is that certainly through your first 4 rounds, you go nice and steady, find a rhythm that you're very capable of sustaining. And then in those last 3, 2 last rounds, you can really speed it up to close out this workout nice and fast. Those 2 speeds are gonna be a step back and a jump back burpee. Again, we're gonna focus on keeping the head up and looking straight ahead to ensure we come to full extension. That means when we jump up and clap, we are upright, not looking at the ground, where our hips don't fully extend. So, I'm going for 4 pausing burpees. We're gonna go step back on these. This is just to make sure we are standing all the way up and that head is focused on the horizon. So I'm gonna step back for these 4. We're going to do the same thing, we're going to go a little bit quicker, we're going to jump down to the floor, jump back up. I'm going to do 2 good ones and then 2 poor ones. Hopefully you can see the difference between the 2 and why we focus on keeping that head on the horizon today. Two good ones, so these are 2 poor ones. Although they're a little quicker, we're not getting that full range of motion as we got jumping up out of the bottom and getting that head, getting that full extension through the hip. Great work, guys. So, if you need to, now's the time to pause the video, get a drink, use the bathroom, anything else you might need to do before you work out, let's get that done now. When you come back, we're gonna talk through this workout one more time, talk about a little bit of strategy, and then we'll get going. Welcome back. So, today we've got double-edged. 7 rounds per time, 30 double unders, 20 10 meter shuttle runs and 10 burpees. This is another one of those workouts where all we're looking to do is stay consistent through these movements. We don't want to go too fast anywhere because 7 rounds is quite a high number of rounds to keep moving for. We don't want to go out too hot and have to slow down towards the end. If anything, what we want to do is speed up. Let's feel this workout out through those first 4 rounds, then we can really look to push the pace in the last 3. Last time, double-edged, 7 rounds, 30 double unders, 20 10 meter shuttle runs, 10 burpees. 3, 2, 1, go.